At this time, we're ready for our show to begin. We'll call our yearling rams over here to the center of the ring, and we'll line you up here in the fashion by age as we have been doing. We want to welcome you here to this morning's show. This is our All Other Breeds contest, and what it is, the breeds that are represented out here in the ring do not have enough entries to have their own breed show. So we put these in a group together, and we call that All Other Breeds. In this class, to the judges far right, we'll have a Merino. We have several Jacobs in this show, and also some Icelandics. So far, this is what we will have out here in the ring that our judge, Mr. Brian Schimmerhorn, will be working. Brian's a noted sheep breeder from Minnesota, and we're glad to have Brian down here again working for us here this morning, and he'll be working the shows all day.
nice way to start off our show here this morning, this AOB division. That can be a little bit more challenging as you go through them, so you just kind of got to look breed for breed and what you're seeing. I think the buck that wins within his breed, I think super nice fleece on this one. I really appreciate that about him, and one that's just really consistent, but yet put some underneath that to make him that stout and backboned and attractive. I think just a really nice, for me, logical place to start. The buck in two, and I think a tremendous fleece on this guy. He's just one, I think, for within his breed, you know, very balanced, a lot of size and scale to this one. He just maybe not quite as neat in the package, but I think two bucks for within their breeds here to start off our show are awful, awful good. And this buck in three, and I think here's one that just a lot of balance and a lot of good in this one. He just gets a little bit lower off his pastures, off his front. If you can study him, I think on the move, though, he's one that's really good in his body. You like the upper third of his skeleton, the structure that he brings, nice enough in his fleece area. Just, I think, a nice combination package. Just maybe see a little more of him to move him up. But I think them first three, being different breeds and stuff, bring a lot of quality. The buck in four, I think, really comparable to the buck right in front of him. He just gets a little out of balance, just breaks right in behind that shoulder. He's got a little more chest to that sheep, just not quite the shape and muscle, and but a nice sheep there as well. And this buck that's getting around these top five here, I think one good in his fleece, and one that goes to the ground really good. As you study him, he just gets a little bit peacier for me as I study him on the move compared to the ones up ahead. But I think a lot of good in him as well. I think a really nice trio of bucks here at the top end for each of them breeds to start off our show here. Congratulations.
Nice job in this class. We'll weigh these first three rams, and then we'll share that with you. If you'd like to follow along, we have programs that are over here on the bleachers, and come on over and pick them up and follow along our show here this morning. Here's the results of our yearling ram class. First place went to Kaylee Scott from Pulaski, Pennsylvania, with Scott's 2531. Our class winner weighed 252 pounds, and he was a Merino. In second place was the Icelandic, exhibited by Daniel Crowning Shield of Ashfield, Massachusetts, with M2P, and he weighed 146. Third place honors went to Victoria Wiggins with ring 1443. He weighed in at 140, and that was Broken Rock Dexter. Fourth place was an entry from Brian McPhee with Skellington Broken Rock 50. Our fifth place yearling ram was exhibited by Michaela Craffey of Massachusetts. And sixth place went to Brian McPhee with Benjamin. Rounding next was Victoria Wiggins with Broken Rock Jolly. And our final ram in the class was from Michaela Craffey on Painted Rock Farm, 1829. And reading down in the book, it will go 1 at 252, 3 at 140, 4, 6, 5, 7, 2 with a weight of 146, and 8.
A really intriguing pair here at the top end of this particular class, and the buck that wins, there's just so much more to this sheep, but again, one built really good at the ground, comes up with enough balance and good, and really like the fleece on this guy. I think just a nice logical place to start in his top pair. I think they're built really similar, just more of that sheep to win the class. This buck in two, highly presented, and I appreciate that about him. Just one that's just a little bit smaller in her stature, but boy, he's balances up good, and he's nice. He's got a nice fleece on him. I think just a really nice pair of bucks here. I think just a little size difference makes and matches that pair up towards the top end. The buck in three, the big scaled buck, and you appreciate the outline on this sheep, no doubt about it. With that, he gets a little bit frailer in the lower third of his body and the center part of his body as we ask him to go to the ground. I just like to widen him out compared to them two that precede him in class there, but a nice fleece on him as well. Congratulations.
We want to make sure we weigh him in the same order as they placed for Jerry. Okay, we're ready for our junior ram lamb class. You may work your way up here to the center of the ring at this time, please.
one of our challenging class here in this spring buck, junior buck lamb class. And I think the sheep that wins, you can put him within his breed. He's really complete. He's ultra big ribbed, and appreciate that about him. I like a hip on this sheep. I think he goes to the ground the truest of anything in this particular class. Yeah, if you're going to change him a little bit, I'd like to raise him right up in his front end and just make him just a tish more attractive. But when he's really big and ribbed and ties together nice, you just like to elevate him a bit. But I'm not going to hold him. He's just really complete, a nice sheep to win. The sheep that comes next is Jacob. I think just one that's really good bone, and really his lines are really good. He goes to the ground nice. I think it's the fleece is desirable enough. I think just from a constructive standpoint, I think he balances up good within the breed and needs to be in second in this particular class. The one that when they first came in, I had picked probably with this class is this 1 and 3, and he's just super, super patterned. I appreciate that about him. He just goes to the ground right. His angles are so good. I just need to strengthen him on his pasterns to move him up. But I think in this particular group, he needed to be in 3 because he's just so striking and intriguing in the way his body is built. Buck in 4, big sheep here, and you appreciate the outer skeleton of this one. He just gets outside himself and his structure off them rear 2. I just need to change him right in his top line a little bit to move him up. But a nice fleece on that sheep. I just need to construct him just a little bit different. The buck that's going to round this top 5, just a little more conventional in his type, but a sheep with a nice fleece on him, I just need to bounce him up, make him just a little bit neater, but he's constructed neat as well. A little more challenging class here, but a nice one to win. Congratulations.
You may begin lining up your pairs of ram lambs at this time. Here's the results in that junior ram lamb class we just finished up with. The first place ram was exhibited by Siri Swanson with Dancing Moon 127. He was a Finn sheep that weighed in at 109. In second place was Victoria Wiggins with Broken Rock Elmer. He weighed 65 pounds, and that was a Jacob. Our third place ram in a class, a Finn sheep, from the Siri Swanson flock on Dancing Moon 126. In fourth place was Kaylee Scott with the Merino from Pulaski, Pennsylvania. Fifth place on a Jacob was Brian McPhee with Broken Rock Swanson. Sixth place honors to Cupid, exhibited by Victoria Wiggins, and a Jacob. Seventh place was a Jacob shown by Daniel Crowning Shield. Eighth place honors went to Michaela Craffey. And in ninth place was Brian McPhee. Our 10th place ram lamb was shown by Michaela Craffey. And 11th place was Daniel Crowning Shield with an Icelandic. And that will read from top down 4, 9, 2 with a weight of 65, 5, 10, 8, and 6. 3 on the next page weighing 95, then 1 weighing 109, 7 and 11. We're going to pick a grand champion ram here of this show at this time. In our pair of ram lamb class, Siri Swanson placed first, followed by Kaylee Scott. Third place honors went to Victoria Wiggins, and fourth place was Brian McPhee. In fifth was Michaela Craffey, and rounding out the class, Daniel Crowning Shield. In our lineup here competing for our Grand Champion Ram here in our All of the Breeds division, we have the first place yearling ram was exhibited by Kaylee Scott. Daniel Crowning Shield with an Icelandic was the runner-up. In our senior ram lamb class, Kaylee Scott of Pennsylvania was first, and Will High Farm of New York placed second. That class-winning ram lamb weighed 195, and the Will High Ram runner-up weighed 153. And our winning junior ram lamb again went to Siri Scott with the Finn sheep, and our second place ram lamb Siri Swanson with with her Finn, and second place Victoria Wiggins with a Jacob.
I think we got a really good lineup here. That makes it look a little interesting when you can put some different breeds out here. But I think out of those particular groups, definitely the best ones in my opinion. But sheep that do bring a lot of quality within their breeds. I think there's two out here. I think when I stand back and analyze them and just think back on them classes of how they looked and the way they're put together and just within their breed and bring them standards to the table, I think a nice place to start in this. Particularly AOB deal, your yearling buck will be your champion. Just a sheep that's just constructed really neat. Just big boned, and you really appreciate the body. They had a nice fleece on him. I think just a really nice, logical place to start. He'll be your champion. We're going to come back down and use that spring junior ram lamb for reserve. Congratulations.
Kaylee Scott with our grand champion ram, and Siri Swanson with the reserve champion. Siri, we'll get your other ram lamb in here, too, for our junior show champion. And here he comes. You got a good shepherd there, Siri. And Siri Swanson has both the champions here in our junior show. Okay, we'll call our first group up here towards the ringside, please.
nice way to start off our female portion here. I think some really good females come in some different types of packages, but I think the ewe that wins, she's just the most complete. You look within a breed, you just look at the center part of her. She's got brood ewe written all over the center part of her body, but yet I think she brings an attractive package. When we ask that one to get out and go, I think she's really true, and I just think a really nice, complete place to start. After that, it got a little bit more challenging. You in second, I think, within her breed. She's not the biggest one, obviously, out in this group, but she's really neatly constructed, really good at the ground, an extra shot of bone that with that. Plenty of rib shape, presented very good. I'd like to change her right in her hip and just level her right in her dock. Just make her right in through there. I think she could push to win this class, but I think within her breed, just a tremendous fleece and just a really nicely constructed one. The pretty one that comes in three and a little more size than this female here, and you appreciate that about her. With that, she gets a little bit finer at the ground. She gets a little bit finer in the center part of her body. I'd like to blow her apart right in through her heart and her rib shape area. Just see a little more of this sheep. But boy, if you're going to stand back and look at one that's pretty and just maybe a notch leveler through her hip compared to the ewe that wins, just need to see more body on that one to move her up in this particular group. And I think this ewe in four kind of follows that same type that the ewe precedes her in class, a different breed, but she just gets a little bit tighter. But with that, she's an attractive fronted one. She's a good topped one. She just reads a little bit frailer. I just like to see more of her as we ask her to go to the ground. This human five, I think body-wise, this one attracts me quite well. A nice fleece on this one. I think within the breed, that's a really nice sheep. For me, at times, I just need to strengthen off its pasterns. It just gets a little bit longer pasturing for me to move it up. But I think you that definitely has got some brighter days ahead in the barn. Congratulations on a nice class.
Here's the placings in our yearling ewe class. First place honors went to Siri Swanson of Orwell, Vermont, with Dancing Moon 107. Our class winning yearling ewe weighed 142, and that was a fin sheep. In second place was Will High Farm of Tivoli, New York, with Will High 1800. She weighed 190, and that was a merino. In third place was Kaylee Scott with a merino on Scott's 2532, and she weighed 199. Our fourth place ewe in class was a fin sheep bred by Siri Swanson with Dancing Moon 106 and the twin sister to the first place ewe. Our fifth place yearling was shown by Michaela Craffey of Massachusetts, and sixth place to Kaylee Scott. Seventh place honors went to Rebecca Southwick with Granger. And that class will read down 5-6-2, weighing 190, 4-1 at 142, 3 at 199, and 7.
Really nice place to start in this class set is you. She just brings a lot to the table. Just then her breed, just a high volume female. You put your hands on her. Definitely doesn't disappoint with the beautiful fleece and just beautiful outline on this one. Just brings a lot to the table, and just I like her quite well. Ewan Second, I think within her breed, just a really a nice pattern sheep. I think she brings an extra shot of length, but with that she holds herself together well. Just maybe not quite as neat in her balance as the youth head wins, but I think one that within her breed, again, like I say, extra shot of bone as she goes to the ground. Just I think a nice female there, just not as much to her as I read her. Ewan Three, I think she's maybe the oddball out in this top five as you look at her, but a nice fleece on this one when you get down in there. I think one that when you get her on the standstill over there, she's one that's just kind of neat in her package and look. I thought she followed her Ewan Second off of well and just needed to be in three. Just not as much of that sheep to move her up any higher. And that's the sake for the one in four, this female beautiful fleece on her. We just need to see more of her, but she just comes in a smaller package with a neat look and just size and scale she needed to be in four. New and five, I think, just from an outline standpoint, needed to be here. Beautiful pattern on this sheep, just not quite as much to her here. Congratulations.
You can line up your pairs of yearling ewes now. Here's the results in our second class of yearling ewes here. Our first place honors went to Daniel Crowning Shield with IC Acres MP3, and she weighed 111. In second place was Michaela Craffey with 247, and that yearling ewe weighed 97. In third place was Brian McPhee with Broken Rocks Carmella, and she weighed 74. Our fourth place ewe was a Daniel Crowning Shield entry with Victoria. Fifth place was exhibited by Rebecca Southwick, and that will be our first place junior show yearling. The sixth place ewe was exhibited by Victoria Wiggins and Brian McPhee, placed seventh. Eighth place was an entry from Victoria Wiggins. And reading that class from top down, it was 3 at 74 pounds, 7, 8, 6. 2 weighing 97, 4 and 1 at 111, and on the next page was 5. Our pair of yearling ewe class winners went to the Finn Sheep from Series Swanson. Second place was Daniel Crowning Shield, and in third place we had Michaela Craffey. Our fourth place pair were exhibited by Kelly Scott. Fifth place went to Brian McPhee, and sixth place Victoria Wiggins, Rounding out the class was Rebecca Southwick. And our class is complete. This is our senior ULAM class here, and it could have a range from September 1st through December 31st. The lambs we have out here are in late October and some December. So this is our senior ULAM class.
I think a really nice pair here at the top end, and just a lot of quality in both of these. The unit wins, just an extra shot of elevation. I really like how that one's constructed. She just brings a lot of good through her front end and her rib shape, and I think she's good enough in her hip, a nice fleece on that one. Just a female you can easily attract to and appreciate her for a lot of things. And I think this Ewan, too, thinner breed, she's kind of neat, too. She's one that I think is really good through her top line. I think she brings an extra shot of extension. She goes to the ground nice. Just maybe not quite as neat in her shoulder if you really study her compared to that U that wins. But I think different breeds there, but just a lot of good in both those. I like them two a bunch. New and three, I think she just doesn't quite balance up. She just gets a little bit more refined in her kind as you study her from the ground, get up into her rib shape and behind her shoulder. She doesn't fill in quite as nice compared to them two up ahead of her, but a nice female on her own right here. A nice pair here at the top end. Congratulations.
Here's the results in our senior ULAM class. First place went to Kaylee Scott from Pulaski, Pennsylvania, with Scott's 2592. She weighed 150 pounds. Our second place honors were won by Michaela Craffey on Craffey's 299, and she weighed 78. And rounding out the class was a Merino from Kaylee Scott on Scott 2593. She weighed 144, and that would read down two at 78, three weighing 144, one at 150.
Really attractive one to win this particular class here, just super in her profile and design. One that when you first see her, just easily to gravitate to out of this particular group here. I think you like the maturity level and just the design of that one. I like her quite well. Using second and third appear to be a little bit bigger than her, and with that they do have a little more size and scale. They got a fair amount more wool on them than the ewe that wins, and this ewe in second, I think when you put your hands on her, just a little bit more sheep there. She's maybe not quite as neat in her next shoulder junction as the ewe that's going to follow her in class, but an extra shot of rib and dimension, just not quite the balance and the look that the ewe that wins. You and three, I think, on the stand, still one that balances up. Put your hands on her, an extra shot of rib and dimension there. Nice fleece on this one. When we ask her to get out and travel, she's just not quite as neat and true as the ones that precede her in class. New that's going to round the group. Really like the youthfulness that she brings. I like the extra shot of bone that she brings. But with that, she can inhale. Just not quite near the sheep there. We just need to see more of that one to move her up. But a nice, interesting class winner here. Congratulations.
Nice class of ewe lambs. Let's weigh these first three. Our class winner was Rebecca Southwick on Craffey's Weasley. Second place in the group went to Brian McPhee with Shadow. In third place was Victoria Wiggins on Elsie. And in fourth place was Rebecca Southwick with Lovegood. Here's the weights on our class winning ewes. The first place ewe from Rebecca Southwick weighed 46. In second place, a Brian McPhee ewe lamb weighed 62. Victoria Wiggins' third place lamb weighed 65. And again, rounding out the class was Rebecca Southwick.
like a really nice one to win this particular class here. This blue-faced Leicester, just well, she brings a lot to the table. Just really elegant her look, and fleece sets is eyeballing off, and just one that's constructed really neat and highly presented. Just really a nice one to start. After that, it gets a little more challenging is this next trio here. I think you can kind of pick and choose them how you like to see them. I think the U in second, there's not as much to this one, but she's the neater balanced one. She's one that's a little higher in the shoulder, just brings me a little more look to her front end. When we ask that one to get out and go, she's the truest through her top line. She really holds herself together well, and I appreciate that about her to get her into second. Colored up one that comes next, really attractive in that aspect of it, a notch more rib in this female. With that, she just gets a little bit lower through her front end. I just like to extend her out through there just to change her as she goes in motion, as well as the one that comes in four. And here's one that just when they get her show and she won, that balances up good. When we ask her to go, I think she gets the most restricted through her top line. Just doesn't quite tie together quite as neat there. But I think an interesting trio there. You can pick them out. You see them. Just not quite the balance in her compared to them ones that are up ahead. Neo that's in five here, I think, within her breed. That's a neat little sheep. I'd maybe like to see just a little more to her at this point, which is okay for this age division. But compared to the ones in front of her, just not quite as neat in her front end. But for the breed, a nice fleece on her. I think a bright future ahead. A nice class winner here. Congratulations.
Okay, you can line up your pairs of ewe lambs. Here are the results of our junior ewe lamb class. Our first place winner was Iris La Rochelle with Sweet Meadows, 1914 on Rio. The class winning lamb weighed 113 and was also first in the junior show. In second place and second also in the junior show was Siri Swanson on Dancing Moon, 19129. That lamb weighed 89. Third place and also third in the junior show is Siri Swanson on Dancing Moon, 128, and that lamb weighed 99. In fourth place was Siri Swanson. Fifth place, exhibited by Daniel Crowning Shield. Kaylee Scott took home the sixth place winner, and in seventh was Brian McPhee. Our eighth place ewe lamb was exhibited by Victoria Wiggins. Michaela Craffey place ninth, and rounding out the class was Daniel Crowning Shield. And again, reading in the book from top to bottom will be 8, 9, 7, 1 at 113, 4, 2 weighing 89, and 3 at 99. And on our next page was 10, 5, and 6. Our pair of ewe lamb class was won by Kaylee Scott. Second place went to Siri Swanson. In third was Daniel Crowning Shield. And fourth place honors went to Michaela Craffey. Our fifth place shoe was exhibited by Rebecca Southwick. Sixth place was Brian McPhee, and our seventh place lamb was shown by Victoria Southwick. We want to recognize our animals out here competing for our Champion U honors here this morning in our all other breeds division. We have the first place Group 1 yearling U-class winner was exhibited by Siri Swanson. We'll be bringing in the Will High U here just in a moment. Our Group 2 class winner was Daniel Crowning Shield. And the runner-up in that class was Michaela Craffey. Okay, we'll recognize our class winners again here. Our first class of yearling ewes was won by Siri Swanson, and the runner-up in that class was Will High Farm from Tivoli, New York. Our Group 2 class winner first was Daniel Crowning Shield, and the second place yearling went to Michaela Craffey. In our senior ewe lamb class, Kaylee Scott with a merino placed first. And our second place senior ewe lamb was exhibited by Michaela Craffey. Our intermediate class winner was Rebecca Southwick. And second place went to Brian McPhee. And the junior ewe lamb class we just completed, first place honors went to Iris La Rochelle. And second place was Siri Swanson.
But a nice AOB show here. I think just some different breeds. It makes it a little bit more challenging, but fun with that. And you just try to give them a shake with what they are for their breed. And I think a lot of good representatives out in this particular lineup, and sheep that went back to the barns, and definitely not all show sheep, and sheep that are going to perform and do well. And so kudos to you guys for breeding what you like and what you can market. That's always the name of the game here. But I think a nice lineup here. I think an easy winner for me out of this particular group here, be this ULM that wins the last class. She's going to be your champion. We're going to go back and use that Yarlin U that wins the second class. That's I for reserve. Congratulations.
Our champion U is Iris La Rochelle. And reserve champion went to the first place yearling ewe in class in the second group of yearling ewes. Daniel Crowning Shield.
junior show champion out of this group, and again, the obvious winner, this ULAM here that wins the open part as well. Just that's a neatly constructed one, and you really appreciate a lot of things about her. For reserve, we're going to go back and use that girl on you up front, that Finn, just a really complete broody type of sheep that brings a lot to the table as well. Congratulations. Let's give these exhibitors a nice round of applause.
We can use some show holders right here just to give these folks a hand. Our exhibitors flock competition was won by Siri Swanson. In second place was Kaylee Scott. Our third place honors went to Daniel Crowning Shield, and Michaela Craffey was fourth. Fifth place was exhibited by Brian McPhee, and rounding out the class was Victoria Wiggin. Our next competition will be the Breeders' Flock. If there are any changes, please let Nancy know. No changes, so it will remain nearly the same. First place going to Siri Swanson, second to Kaylee Scott, third to Michaela Craffey, fourth place to Brian McPhee, and fifth place to Victoria Wiggin. And now we can line up those that have entries in our Get of Sire class. Four animals, both sexes represented, all sired by the same ram. Here in our Get of Sire, first place went to Kaylee Scott. Second was shown by Siri Swanson. And third place was Michaela Craftke. Fourth place went to the Dan Crowning Shield Flock. And fifth place honors were won by Brian McPhee. And our final group of four here, our Get of Sire, was shown by Victoria Wiggins. Our next and final class will be the judging of our best fleeced sheep from the All Other Breeds division. So each exhibitor may bring in one animal for the best fleece competition. Our best fleece winner in the All Other Breeds division went to Wilhigh Farm from New York. Congratulations to the Wilhigh flock, Chuck and Heidi Simmons. We need a representative of the Kaylee Scott and Siri Swanson flocks here to the ring, please. We have them both here. Our Premier Exhibitor Award winner, and folks, we want to introduce here is Kaylee Scott, wins our Premier Exhibitor here. Let's give Kaylee a nice round of applause on a job well done. And Siri Swanson, you are our Premier Breeder winner here in our All Other Breeds Award. Let's give them both a nice round of applause again for a good job. And we'll get some pictures here with the judge, too.